All right, thanks a lot. I'd like to give you a demo, a little bit of a walkthrough of this Excel books accounting application. It is really an incredible application. I want to take a little bit of time to show you some of the amazing features and benefits with this application. It comes with a complete toolbar up here. I can go to anything just by clicking this toolbar above. The admin settings, if of course the user has those rights, they'll be able to change the currency, the time, date, phone, percent, and the start date all throughout the application. So one change with this currency is going to change all the currencies inside the application. That's going to go with time and date as well. We'll be able to customize the phone types, and if there's any updates, they're going to be able to show here. Company information, all the company information, that those are the kinds of things that could appear on invoices and purchase orders and credit memos if you want that there. And we also have custom fields here, so that's really helpful if your company has some specific field that's not provided in the billing address or shipping address or something like that. You can provide them in the custom fields. We just set a name and then a set of value, and it's there. User settings, really, really important. This application does have user sharing and sync. And what does that mean? That means any user throughout the world can share and sync this application at the same time. You can assign those users in the user lists and rights. You can turn this feature off or turn it on here. Once you turn it on, you can set different fields like allowing passwords and remembering usernames and a lot of different settings. So that's really great. User lists and rights. Here we can add users, right? So we can not only add, but edit specific users. If we want to edit a user, we'll just click here and we can edit the information, whether it's a password, email, or their role. Each user can assign a role. So you can assign up to four different roles here. And these roles could be for any type. So we can set access or set editable rights, such as the admin access, or such as maybe you want general journal access, or maybe you want them to be able to view invoices but not create them, or maybe you want them to be able to make deposits. So all these different settings on a per user basis. You can add a new user just by clicking here, and you can edit a user by clicking here. Relatively simple. Accounts and settings, you can set default accounts. Really a great way. Easily set default accounts for all the types. Generally, you just have to set these once. You got pay terms and methods, so you can set payment terms based on bill due dates, payment methods, and tons. We got vocabulary naming. This is super powerful. Maybe you don't want to call them customer, and maybe you want to call it client, or maybe you want to call it contact. All you need to do is change it here, and it's going to change throughout the application. Same thing with vendors and everything ever. So custom vocabulary, really, really powerful, really good to use, so that this application can be customized to your own requirements. The way you're doing things is the way you want to do them, and that allows you to do that. Also, we can enable or disable sharing and sync just by that, and we'll set a shared folder on here. Automate emails and notifications, we'll get into that. You can set some defaults here. Customer defaults, every customer can have an automatic custom field. So let's say you want to put credit limit, and you can do that here, and then all you want to do is just set the field type. Of course, it's going to be a currency, and then you can set the format of that, which is really, really powerful, and then a default value, so that's going to automatically change. You can also have a list. Maybe you want something like customer type or something like that. You can either do a custom list. So if we do list, we can then edit the custom list here, so all we need to do is just click on here, and if this was a list type, let's say we want to put something like customer type here. And then we can set a format if we want. We've got all different types of formats here. And also, if we want to edit that list, we can. We can edit anything in that list. We can add new items. And that's going to go for each one of those. So if we have a list here as well, we can add that list here. So each specific custom field can have its own list type, can have its own list items. So lots of different possibilities with the custom field. Now, custom fields are available also in vendor settings. They're also available in item settings. So you can have that even with items. Items, you have product types, item locations, default products. So custom fields can be throughout. Purchasing defaults, again, also with these go on purchase orders. We can also have a default footer message too. If we click on here, we can set our default footer message. Clicking on here, we can customize that footer message. That's going to go below purchase orders or the invoices or anything else. So that's a custom footer message, and we'll go over that a bit. Invoices and credit memos, same thing, custom fields, default footer message. We can have a default save as, a default email as, and tons of defaults. So that's basically the admin and settings there. And now also, we've got an incredible dashboard with over 14 reports, and it's going to include a company overview. We've got a drill down profit and loss. It's going to allow us to drill down into specific transactions automatically just by clicking on here, drill down, drill up. But date range, we've got tons of different, just by changing the date range, it's automatically going to change. So a lot of different options here, and that's going to be for many, many reports that we can do. Just check on this. We can also do custom dates. If we select on a specific date, we can do custom dates, and that's going to be for any report very, very easily. And we also have the previous period or show showing a previous period, so we can show or hide the previous period on this one. So that's going to be coming in handy. Trial balance, also very, very important. So we've got the trial balance here, and we can do it as of any specific date. A balance sheet, a really full balance sheet, so we have that. Cash flow calendar is really, really important, so we can see that our cash flow. If we change the date on here, we can see like the next month it'll go to red. That means our cash flow is going to go down. So we need to keep an eye on that on a specific day. How's our cash flow looking? It can be based on any specific account here. If we want to eliminate certain accounts or include certain accounts, we can. An aging payables report, any report. Also, we can do this if we want to show or hide certain columns. We can toggle those columns. All we need to do is just say if we don't want to show aging days and due dates, we can just unselect and do that. And also we can do is making this a custom report. If we like the way this looks with just those three columns missing and we want to show only this, all we need to do is just click save as a custom report. We've got save as Excel, PDF, picture, or custom reports. Just click on the custom report and assign it a name. Just call this aging custom. And we can just simply save it, and that's going to be available in our custom reports. And all we need to do is we have a list of custom reports. All we need to do is click this again. It's going to refresh, and it's going to have those columns missing just the way we want it, just those custom columns. So creating custom reports is a great way. We can also rename it. All we need to do is just click rename. So custom reports. We also have aging receivables, sales by customers, purchase orders. We've got a profit and loss graph here. We've got, it depends on the date. We can change the dates. Let's do set the last year to date, so we can do last year, last custom, this month, any way you want. It's going to show our custom. We've got inventory reorder reports. This is really cool. If we have inventories that are falling below certain levels and we need to know we need to order those inventories, we can have a list of vendors that's going to show us. So all we need to do is click on the vendor and say, okay, this vendor has items, and all we want to do is just click create purchase order. It's going to automatically create that purchase order based on those required items, just like this. So that's a really, really cool feature. Okay, so back into the dashboard we go. A few other reports that I wanted to show you. We have inventory on hand worksheet. This is going to allow us to adjust the inventory items on hand, just change those quantities up here and there. And that's all we need to do is just adjust those quantities. So if we want to put that we have only found in, let's say, 60 of those items and 50 of these items, we know it's a deduction. Then all we need to do is just save that transaction. And based on a specific account, we can set the account. Let's just say we got an inventory adjustment here. We've got an adjustment account. We can click make adjustments. It's going to enter that transaction automatically and make those adjustments. It's going to set those correct. Now we've got the correct inventory item on hand, and it's credited the proper expense account. Inventory reorder, bill payments, and our net worth graph. We've got a lot of really cool features on this. That's it for the dashboard. We can access any report from the toolbar here just by clicking here if we want to click it, or any custom report just by clicking here. Chart of accounts, a very, very cool report. Lots of different accounts. Just going to show the accounts. Every individual transaction, we can see those individual transactions. We can view the individual transaction just by clicking here. Also, we've got intertransactions here, right? We can enter any type of check, e-payment, or receipt. Here we've got check. We can enter checks. We can enter e-payments, or of course, receipts. We can also enter bills and credits. So if we want to enter a bill for a specific vendor, we can have a specific account. Just select a vendor on here. Let's do one with a this vendor, and maybe we want to put in some delivery. We've got let's say a delivery cost of $15, and let's say we've got some items that we've purchased from that vendor. So maybe we want some blue t-shirts, maybe we've ordered some pink t-shirts, and so we can set the quantity. And we see we've ordered, the total is $85, so we can just set the amount in here. And let's say we want to show decimals. All we need to do is go into the admin, go into the general application, and then change that currency. So let's say we want, now it's changed all throughout the application. So if we go back inside intertransaction, we're going to see that those formats have now changed. So now we show in the decimals. So you see how easy that changes. We can set a bill due date in specific terms if it's due on the 30th, or we set a discount date on that, assign it a memo. Right? If it's not in balance, if for some reason the items and the expenses don't add up to what we've put on here, it's going to let us know that this total expense has got to be $85. The total items plus the total expenses must equal $85. Okay, so we can change that. So it lets us know. Very cool. We can save the transaction here. And once it's saved, we got a lot of other options. We can create, make this reoccurring. If we want to make this transaction reoccurring, You can make it recurring every day, every week, or every month. Even if it's on the month, it could be every last, first day or week or month, Tuesday. Lots of options for reoccurring. So it's going to automatically create that specific bill every month or however often you send it. So that's transactions or intertransactions, super powerful. We can assign a purchase order, memo, lots of things we can do with that. Also, we have been able to write checks in here. Also, again, we're able to enter credit card, general journal. We've got a really powerful general journal allowing us to put in compound items. We can refresh this. We can select a specific account or we can select a specific date range that we want to see. If we want to view a specific bill payment or specific check, we just click on here. It's going to take us right to that transaction here. Very, very easily on the general journal. Making transfers also, if we've got, can make transfers between accounts. Also really powerful here in the make transfer. Recurring transactions, a list of all those recurring transactions. You can edit them. It's going to edit that information. You'll see a list. You can make them active or inactive. We also can reconcile accounts. Reconcile accounts is really, really important. We can select specific accounts. If it's not in balance, it's going to tell us. So we can select those specific transactions. We can select a specific account, a reconciled date, ending balance, and a lot of other information. We can set an account, some service charges, as well as interest, and make sure that those accounts are in balance. Once we do, it's going to show that those are cleared. So reconciling, really cool. Printing checks, very, very cool. Be able to print checks. We've got three different check formats, whether it's on a voucher, a standard, or wallet. We can set it up. We can set the initial check number. We can select a printer that we want to use, and we can adjust the margins, edit the layout. Customizing the layout is going to turn it into edit mode and allow us to drag and drop and completely customize this, and that allows us to more edit in the edit mode and print those checks. Printing checks, super powerful. Customers and invoice, we got customer information, of course. We've got all the invoice history, the payment information. We got attachments. We can attach anything we want to those customers. General information is going to show those custom fields that we talked about earlier. Those custom fields will appear here. And that's for customers. Of course, new customer, delete customer. Now, also we have a customer list here. We'll be able, just like with any list, we'll be able to use a single click on sorting, or we'll be able to filter any specific customer if we want just by looking for it. We can filter that or clear that filter out. That goes with any list, whether it's customers, vendors, items, and so on and so forth. All right, we've got customer payments. If customers could be able to make a payment, so the customer's paid us $600, we can then apply that payment to multiple invoices if we want. And once we run out of invoices, it's going to let us know that we can't apply those anymore. So we can apply specific amounts to specific invoices, and we can apply them to credit. If a customer has a credit, we can apply those to unused credit memos. Very, very powerful customer payments information. I know I'm moving fast. So much to show you in this incredible application. Making deposits, once the customer is paid, we can then take those payments and make deposits here. Just select on whichever ones we want to make, and we can deposit a specific ID or view payments, and we can select what account to deposit it in. If we've got any cash back, we could put that transaction in here. You can navigate to previous deposits as well. All right, so we have that make deposits in the customer information. We also have invoices. Invoices are super powerful. We're going to be able to do these. Here's our invoices, but most importantly, we can customize these invoices. So if we click customize, we can then show if we want to show or hide. We have invoice details if we want to show or hide. If we want to put in a delivery time, we can then put that in here. We can customize it any. We can drag it up. And then once we do, we can customize that. We can add anything we want to this. We can change the font size, the text color, the fill color, the border color. If we want to add a border, a red border around it, we can just add that, or green border, just by doing that. And we can change the border thickness and the font size just by increasing it. Doing so many things with it, adding a fill color if we want. If we don't want to show that, all we do is just click here and hide it, and just click here and hide it. This is going to allow us to customize invoices exactly how we want them using this custom invoice. Customer details are here. We can show or hide any customer details if we want to show them here. First name or last name if we want to put that here. All right, so that's finished. Once we're finished customizing, we've got an invoice. This is a floating footer. We can put as many lines as we want. This footer will move down. Notice, remember we talked about this footer message. Remember we have a default footer message. That's what this message is here. We can select different footer messages just by clicking here. So setting that footer message on your invoice so it's going to show up. And we can just insert the selected note, and it's going to insert. Now we've got a different footer message there. It's going to display on that floating footer. Going to put up to two taxes. We can duplicate, make the recurring, apply payment, void it, delete it. printing to a specific printer if we want a drop-down list of printer, email it as a PDF picture or embedded picture, or save it as a PDF. Very, very powerful tools inside this invoice. All right, so that's the invoicing application. We've got credit memos, almost the same as invoices, customizing it just like we do invoicing, but this is when we want to offer a customer a specific credit. So this is a great and powerful tool. When we want to show, give customers credits, we can do just that, selecting specific item. All this is controlled by inventories. And we also have the credit memo list and customer attachments. We've got a full vendor information, purchase order history, bill payments for that vendor, and attachments that we can attach to that vendor, selecting on a specific vendor, and we have vendor list as well. Vendor attachments, we have the ability to enter bills. We saw that screen already in the enter. We bill payments, we'll be able to pay those bills. We can select bills that we want to pay and the method of that we want to pay them. Also, which account that we want to do, payment date, and the check payment number, and then the discount if we want. We can set a discount to a specific one. And also what we do have, purchase orders. Purchase orders are similar to invoices and credit memos. Also the ability to customize those, creating a very custom purchase order and a floating footer. If we want to set a footer message, we can do that exactly just like we did previously. We just need to set a message, and our purchase order will also have a footer message. We can show or hide this. We can customize this footer message however we want. Once we click customize, only then can we customize this. So that's only in the customization mode. Very, very cool and powerful tools on the purchasing order. Okay, great. We've got last thing we got to show you, email automation. This is the amazing email automation. We can automate and trigger emails and trigger notifications on pretty much anything we want. So for example, if a purchase order is updated, we want this information to show up. We have a trigger. We can trigger this on anything, on a credit memo, on a customer, on an item. And then, like for example, purchase order, we could do when this purchase order is updated, when it's created. And with over 60 different triggers, we've got a ton of triggers. Notice each trigger has a different type of variable. So for example, purchase orders can have information and variables based on the purchase order, while a credit memo is going to have information based on the credit memo. So you'll be able to insert that information into a specific email or into a pop-up note if we have those enabled. And what does that mean? That means when we create a purchase order, for example, if I create or update, in this case, update, it's going to automatically create an email. And you'll see that email contains the purchase order and it contains all the purchase order information. We also have a notification, so that way we can get pop-up notifications. All right, I'm so glad I got to walk you through this. I know it was quick, I know there's a lot more to show you, but I wanted to give you a rundown of the amazing features and benefits of this accounting application. Okay, thanks so much.